Hey guys, I'm Mr. Echo back with another video. Today I have a list of 10 new Minecraft mods for Minecraft 1.16.1. I'll put links in the description to all the mods, so please check those out if you're interested in downloading one or two mods of today's list. And let's get straight into the video. Today we start with Gilded Armor. This mod makes it possible to add gold to your netherite armor, which will keep piglins neutral, just like when you wear a golden armor piece. This is a very simple but brilliant idea because you no longer have to worry about changing your armor or be afraid that your golden armor will break because of its low durability. Adding a piece of gold to your armor will not change the properties of your netherite armor, and it also looks kinda cool. Actually Useful Stonecutter adds 134 new recipes to the stonecutter. Honestly, I'm usually too lazy to craft a stonecutter for those few extra stairs you get out of it, but with this mod it's absolutely worth it to make one. All types of logs can now be cut into planks, strip logs and boats, and all types of planks can be cut into fences, fence gates, pressure plates, signs, slabs, stairs, trapdoors, balls and sticks. String can be cut from wool, cobblestone can be cut into gravel, and brick blocks can be turned back into single bricks. Next is Gentle Fawn. This mod adds a deer to the game. There are two varieties, one with an antler and one without. These deer look absolutely great and I'll definitely be using this mod in my mod packs from now on. They are breedable with wheat and they drop venison when killed. With Fruitful you can now see the apples in trees, so you no longer have to chop down an entire tree or break all leaves and then hope for an apple to fall out. Breaking leaves with apples will now always give you an apple. Next to apples there are currently also peaches in this mod, and more fruit like pears, oranges and pineapples will be added soon. There are also new food items added in this mod, the apple pie and the peach cobbler, and all other fruits that will be added will likely come with new food recipes as well. Next is Obsidian Extension. This mod makes obsidian and crying obsidian more useful by adding stairs, slabs, walls and buttons for both blocks. In future updates more items will be added to this mod, like doors and pressure plates. With color bricks you can now have bricks in all 16 colors in Minecraft. Just use a piece of dye on regular bricks like so to change the color and you can re-dye the bricks as much as you like. You can also use the stonecutter to make your slabs, stairs and walls. Lantern Colors is an absolutely amazing mod that adds many new colored lanterns to Minecraft. Besides the regular lantern and the soul lantern, there are now 16 new lantern colors. The lanterns can be dyed with a glass panel, and like the Color Bricks mod, they can also be re-dyed as many times as you like. In fact, both the Color Bricks mod and the Lantern Color mod go pretty well together when you're going for a certain color theme. Or you can of course alternate between different colors to add some variation to your builds. You can really go crazy with these two mods. You'll be able to create some amazing looking structures with these mods in combination with some other vanilla blocks in the game. Next is Simple Magnets. Simple Magnets adds magnets that can pick up items and experience around the player. There are two types of magnets, the basic magnet and the advanced magnet. The basic magnet picks up items and experience within a 5 block range of the player. You can easily turn the magnet on or off by simply right clicking it. When it's turned on, it will glow like an enchanted piece of equipment. The advanced magnet can also be turned on and off by a right click, and it picks up items and experience within a configurable range. To open the advanced magnet's interface, you need to right shift click it. Here you can individually adjust the pickup range for items and experience up to 11 blocks. You can also choose to only pick up items or experience, and you can black or whitelist items. Trash cans adds 4 different types of trash cans to the game. There's the item trash can that can be used to get rid of any item by placing the item in a slot here. You can also white or blacklist some items here below. There's the liquid trash can that can be used to empty your bucket that contains a certain liquid. Then there's the energy trash can. This trash can be used to toss out energy such as redstone. And the ultimate trash can be used for all three purposes at once. And the last mod of today is Villagers Respawn. This mod makes it so that when villagers die, they will respawn next to their bed if they slept in one. It's a very much needed mod with all the attacks villagers suffer from these days. And very handy if you have a villager in your world with a great trait and you don't want to lose him in an attack by pillagers or zombies. Alright, that was all for today's video. Again, check the description for download links to the mods we've covered today. And if you enjoyed this video and would like to see more of these in the future, please like and subscribe and share this video with your friends. My name is Mr. Echo, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye bye.